A hospital in southeastern Connecticut says that it hasn't seen any increase in heat-related health problems yet, but they say they are ready.
Doctors say in this heat, the most vulnerable among us, including people like the elderly, those with respiratory problems, need to really take precautions. News 8's Tina Detail continues our team coverage. She is live on the scene in Norwich.
Here at the William Backus Hospital's emergency room, they've only had a couple of heat-related cases, but folks here expect as the temperatures rise, those cases will increase as well. So far, folks have been treated for dehydration, but the ailments could become more serious as heat and humidity persist.
When it's hot, the body expends more energy to lower its temperature, so that means more oxygen needs, and patients with shortness of breath already at baseline are going to have trouble in the heat.
Dr. Tinesh Dahanayake is in the pulmonary critical care department at the Norwich Hospital. He sees patients with lung problems, those among the most vulnerable in this weather.
It's particularly important that these patients use their medications. They look at the weather reports and make sure that the heat index is not up. And if it is, maybe they want to avoid these outdoor activities.
Or at least wait until temperatures drop and drink plenty of fluids. The latter good advice for everyone in avoiding heat stroke.
They can have changes in their mental status, low blood pressure, headaches, nausea, and that could be serious and even life-threatening.
To date, we haven't seen any increase in additional respiratory breathing kind of emergencies.
But Greg Allard suspects that may change. He says American Ambulance has opened up the vending machines so crews can keep hydrated.
Free water, free Gatorade, that type of stuff during these types of days.
And with calls expected to increase, keeping these crews healthy can only help in any emergency. On the scene in Norwich, Tina Detail, News 8.